as you'll now see as we join our commentators, Hugh Porter and Phil Liggett.
And so as the little Downey pacer comes round the track for the start of the final, the gun goes and Robert Dilbundi goes off, the leader of the string. And there's the Downey picking up Dilbundi at the front, the 1980 amateur Olympic champion, now a professional, and in this final. Behind him, Gordon Singleton of Canada, and the little figure of Noda from Japan in third place. Danny Clark, not had a very good draw, but he's lying now in fifth place, while Dilbundi is tucked in nicely. And Clark moving up lovely there, Clark coming right through on the inside. This rough, tough Australian who celebrates his 31st birthday just 3 days from now, trying for his third world title behind the Downey in the Kieran. Dilbundi still tucked in second place. In first place, rather, the Italians are moving up from their back. And there's a little bit of elbow showing going on there between Capincelli, I think it was, and certainly Danny Clark. So this is the vital place. Clark always favours the second position, and he will fight to hold it. And so the pace lifts up now to 28 miles an hour before the riders will be dispatched. They're bringing it round now, and Dilbundi on the shoulder of Clark in the red jersey with a white cross on it. Into the home straight now, glance over the shoulder. This is the last lap now before the riders are given their head. Clark has fought, battled and won for that first place behind the motorbike. And this is the ride of a defending world champion. Clark in first place, tucked in nicely now. The West German rider, Piston, in second place. Gordon Singleton in third place from Canada. Clark, remember, 3 days from his 31st birthday, going for his third world title in the Kieran. And Clark leads it out, followed by Piston. Singleton trying in third place. And look at the elbows going there. Piston and Singleton getting on all sorts of trouble. Danny Clark is profiting by that. Clark coming off the banking in first place. Danny Clark, and on the line, Gordon Singleton of Canada has taken the gold medal. Danny Clark was in third place, and in second place rather, and what a finish that was. And Gordon Singleton of Canada is a world champion in only his second year as a professional. What a fabulous final that was, and this ever so nice man off the bicycle is an absolute demon on it.
Well, Singleton first across the line, but protests all round from the Italian, from the West German and from the Australian. Phil Liggett now looks at a rerun of the race.
Well, as we've seen in the heats, this Kieran race has always threatened to be a rough, tough final, and really that's exactly what it's been. Even here where Danny Clark has claimed first place, he's had a tough passage behind that Downey. In second place, Kristen has always looked good and always been full of fight, quite literally with his elbows and his shoulders. In third place, Gordon Singleton. Now with the Downey out of the way, one lap to go as the clock comes on, Danny Clark seems to have a clear run to his third world title. Kristen in second place, going well too. Then comes the run on the shoulder there, the West German, of Gordon Singleton, and that was the first clash. Now there's the second one, and look at the way Singleton is trying to fend off the West German. Now the West German, to me, is the man at fault there. So Singleton, not taking any stick at all, brings his arms out, gets entangled, and lets go of the West German. And if we look at the top of the picture now, you'll see the Belgian there in the yellow band on his blue jersey collide now with the Italian Concentini. Now, the Italian there was again trying to come through, and the Belgian, I think, was at fault, and that's why the Italians have protested. But on the line, there's no doubt that Singleton has won, and no doubt, too, that Danny Clark has got a good second place, and Turu Kitamura in third spot.